Hello guys, and welcome back to another video from Vipin Sharma Biology Tutorials. In this video, we are going to talk about Osteichthyes or the bony fishes. In the last lecture, we have talked about the cartilaginous fishes and some important aspects or characters of bony fishes as well in the form of comparison. But in this video, we will specifically talk about bony fishes. And the most important thing or the way to learn all the characters is the comparison. So, हमने जो cartilaginous fish में पढ़ा उसको हम इस पर्टिकुलर लेक्चर में डालने की कोशिश करेंगे क्योंकि सारे कैरेक्टर्स अप्रोक्सीमेटली सेम है बट जो कैरेक्टर्स डिफरेंट है वो मैं आपको बता दूंगा जिससे कि आपको एक कंपैरेटिव वे में bony fishes के भी सारे कैरेक्टर्स याद हो जाएंगे. सो द वेरी फर्स्ट थिंग इज दैट द फिशेस यूज टू लिव इन वॉटर. ओके, नाउ हियर कम्स अ वेरी मेजर डिफरेंस. In case of chondrichthyes, we have seen that they were mostly present in marine water. Okay, I will be writing some important characters of cartilaginous fish over here. Okay, and bony fish over here. So they are usually marine water fish. Okay, most of them are marine water. Lekin, in case of bony fishes, they can be marine water fishes as well as freshwater fishes. So this is the first character. And the first difference as well. The body is streamlined in case of marine water fish, or we can say the cartilaginous fishes, and the body is streamlined in case of Osteichthyes as well. Ye character same hai. In case of the endoskeleton, it is bony in Osteichthyes. Osteo simply means bones. It means that the endoskeleton is formed up of bones in case of bony fishes. Naam mein hai yaar, bony fishes matlab bone. Cartilaginous fishes matlab cartilage. So the endoskeleton is a very important difference. After that, the mouth is terminal. In case of cartilaginous fishes, the mouth is present on the ventral side. Lekin yahan par mouth bilkul terminus pe present hoga. The mouth will be present on the terminal side. This is the major difference. Okay. So in case of cartilaginous fishes, the mouth will be present on the ventral position. But in case of bony fishes, the mouth will be present on the terminal end. Okay. After that, four pairs of gill slits are present. Okay. अब सीधी सी बात ये है कि gill slits दोनों में present थी. That's fine. But the operculum is also present on each side. It means that it is the gill cover. In case of cartilaginous fishes, the operculum or the gill cover was absent. But in case of bony fishes, there are four pair of gills which are, you know, surrounded by or covered by the operculum on each side. It means that the gill cover is present. This is the simple difference. After that, the skin is covered by cycloid or tenoid scales. But in case of the cartilaginous fishes, there are placoid scales. And that placoid scales are also modified to form the teeth, which are very strong and they are directed backwardly. Okay, backward direction mein directed hote hain wo. Aur wo bante hain placoid scale ki modification se. But in case of bony fishes, there are no placoid scales. There are either cycloid scales or tenoid scales. So, जो स्किन होती है वो कवर्ड होती है स्केल्स से. ओके, जस्ट लाइक दैट. एंड दो स्केल्स आर साइक्लॉइड और टिनॉइड स्केल्स इन केस ऑफ बोनी फिशेस. द एयर ब्लैडर इज प्रेजेंट. नाउ कार्टिलेजिनस फिशेस हैव टू स्विम कॉन्स्टेंटली. वेन एवर दे विल स्टॉप स्विमिंग, दे विल श्योरली सिंक इन द वॉटर. वाई? बिकॉज इन दैट केस द एयर ब्लैडर इज एबसेंट. बट द बोनी फिशेज डोंट हैव टू स्विम कॉन्स्टेंटली because they have an air bladder. Okay. After that, the heart is two-chambered, which is common character of both the fishes. They are cold-blooded or poikilothermous. It simply means that they cannot regulate their internal constant body temperature. Unka body temperature fluctuate hota rehta hai external environment condition ke saath saath. So, andar ki conditions ko maintain theek se nahi kar paate, isiliye hum inhe bolte hain cold-blooded. और पॉइकिलोथर्मल. right? So both of the fishes are poikilothermous in nature. The sexes are separate. It means that there is a male and there is a female. This character is same in both the fishes. And in case of cartilaginous fishes, the male have claspers. Okay, the pelvic fin bear claspers. So you can easily distinguish between the male and the female. After that, the fertilization is external, but in case of cartilaginous fishes, it is internal. They are oviparous. It means that they used to lay eggs, but in case of cartilaginous fishes, they are mostly viviparous. It means that they give rise to the young ones directly. And their development is direct. It means that there is no larval stage. So these are some important characters of bony fishes. You have to learn all the characters in the form of similarities and differences. There are some similarities. For example, the body is streamlined in both the cases. Okay? The body is streamlined in both the cases. Both of them are cold-blooded. Both of them are having two-chambered heart. And both of them are having sexes separate. It means that male and female are different. So these are some similar characters which are present in both of them. But the difference is now that this particular bony fish is marine plus fresh, but the cartilaginous fishes are only marine. After that, the endoskeleton is bony. In cartilaginous fishes, it is cartilaginous. The mouth is terminal, but in cartilaginous fishes, it is ventral. Okay, the operculum is present here, but operculum is absent in cartilaginous fish. There are cycloid and ctenoid scales, but in cartilaginous fishes, there are placoid scales. The air bladder is absent, but air bladder is present in, the air bladder is present in case of bony fishes, but it is absent in case of cartilaginous fishes. That's why they have to swim constantly. Two-chambered heart is the same character. Cold-blooded is the same character. These are also same character. This is internal in case of cartilaginous fishes. Cartilaginous fishes are mostly viviparous. So these are the major differences, guys. Okay. After watching these two videos carefully, the Osteichthyes and Chondrichthyes, you can easily memorize all the characters because I have repeated the characters approximately 5 times. So ek video ke dauran aap itni baar kisi character ko sunenge to aapko sare characters obviously yaad ho jayenge. And in the form of comparison, jaisa ki humne kiya, it is more easier to understand a particular thing. You just have to focus on those characters which are different. Okay? And learn the character of one category only, and for other, you can easily derive that particular character. For example, aapne agar ye scales ke naam yaad kar liye, ya operculum yaad kar liya, ya air bladder yaad kar liya, Osteichthyes ke liye, then you just have to reverse the case. For example, air bladder present, absent. Operculum present, absent. Then you can easily make the characters. Okay? Us tarike se aap log apni padhai ko zyada aasan bana sakte hai kyunki the syllabus is very vast. So I hope that you enjoyed the lecture very well. Agar aapko lecture pasand aaya, then do hit like button. Share this video with your friends. Subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon for sure. Thank you so much.